One of the main techniques in generative art is the following. You take a shape, draw it several times, and change some parameters considering the position of a shape in space, a rotation, a size, a color, or whatever. This technique is relatively simple yet powerful, and this is the base of most works of such artists as Vera Molnar, a pioneer of generative art. Vera created her works with Fortran and basic programming languages, but we can recreate them using Nodes in Touch Designer. Not just in order to replicate the work, but to study from her and be able to express our own vision. Let's start! Create a rectangle sop. Then null sop. I'll call it quad. Then insert a geometry component. To keep only borders, create a line material and apply it by dragging the material node to the geo. I usually set the same slightly decreased value for width near and width far. In the line tab, make the line white and disable line far color. Reduce the size of the rectangle. Now we want to create a grid of rectangles, which can be done in multiple ways. The most powerful one is probably instancing, but despite being an efficient technique, it does have some restrictions. Since we're gonna distort rectangles, we will use the replicator. Before that, I'll create one more geometry component and put all this inside. Let's call it quad 0. Then let's create a constant chop and call it size. We'll define the amount of rectangles there to refer to this chop later. Add one more channel, call them like rows and calls, and let it be 4 by 4. To duplicate rectangles, we'll use the replicator component. Drag your quad into master operator field and change the replication method to by number. To define the number of replicants, we need to multiply these values. Now, these nodes are just copies of the master operator. Let's arrange them in a grid. Go inside the master operator. Create a grid sop. Even though it is SOP, we can use it as a source of position data. Let's open the display options and make the points visible. We want these rows and columns to be the same as the amount of rectangles, so let's get these values. Create a select chop, call it select size. We need to refer to the size operator, and since it's one level upper, we type double dot slash size. Connect this to the grid. The next step, convert grid to chops, and then add a trim chop. Set unit values to absolute. Now, when we change the start point, it extracts coordinates for just one point. It works like selection by index. This value should be unique for each replicant, so we simply type parent parentheses dot digits. The script will take a value from the name of the replicant. Let's put a null here and call it pose. Create a transform sop after the rectangle and connect the position values to it accordingly. We'll leave that coordinate as it is, but you can experiment with it too later. Let's go back. To update the replicator, we should click Recreate all operators. We'll need it further many times, so let's put a keyboard in chop here and connect to Recreate all operators. Now, each time I press 1, it updates the replicator. Add the render top and camera. And now we have a grid. While working in 2 dimensions, I usually set camera to orthographic because it just doesn't create any depth distortions related to the perspective. Let's set a resolution here, mine will be vertical. Add RGB key top to make the background black. Divide the screen in 2 sections. Display. Deselect background tops. And select top viewer. Now the more interesting part. Let's distort rectangle. I want the distortion to smoothly increase every next column. To do that, go to the master operator and add a noise sub. Press 1 to update the replicator. And we see nothing. The reason why we see distortion here, but not in the render, is because the noise sub displays points along the normals, which are in Z-axis in our case. And since our camera is set to orthographic, we don't see anything that happens in that coordinate. The easiest way to apply noise to X and Y axis is to add one more noise sub and set the first one's attribute to point normal. Type random. So now the first noise randomizes our normals and the second displaces the positions of each point in every axis. Let's randomize the seed of each rectangle with the tiny script we already know. Zoom to the grid and in the display options enable point numbers. The points are sorted by rows, so let's deal with them instead of columns. We can always rotate the image later. So we want the noise amplitude to increase every row. Enable scripting. Parent parentheses dot digits will return us the values that corresponds with these indexes, which we want to divide by 4. Update. Double slash is not a regular division, it's so-called integer division, which is a very simple thing. It just gives us a quotient without remainder, so it's gonna be 0 for all the values in the first row, 1 for values in the second, and so on. Okay, that works. Maybe it's a little too much, so I'll just multiply this by 0.5. What else we can do is to replace 4 with our columns number, so that we don't have to go back to the stroke if we want to change the number of rectangles later. The next step is to increase the amount of rectangles to overlap each other. We want to keep the first row as it is and add one more layer to the second row, 2 more layers to the next one, and so on. Let's create a new replicator for this. Set quad 0 as the master operator, replication method by number. Select these nodes, right-click, and collapse selected. We've created sort of a folder to keep all the nodes there. Rename this to maybe rect 0 and replace the master operator. Let's also add one keyboard inchop to refresh this replicator. Instead of setting the number of replicants manually, we want to make one layer of rectangles if they are in the first row, 2 layers in the second, and so forth. So we'll type parent parentheses dot digits double slash 4. Let's insert our top instead of RGB key here. Zoom out and put an overtop. And place RGB key top. We want to connect each replicant's output to this top, and we can do it with a single stroke here. Refresh. All right. But to make it work, we have to redistribute rectangles according to the main indexes. So we put a constant chop here and call it index. Type parent parentheses dot digits to get indexes. Then go inside and create inchop. And no, which I also call index. Connect this. Select the trim operator and set the index here instead. And in the noise sub, I'll multiply index to the seed to get the unique seed for each rectangle. Let's also randomize normal's noise. Let's make the grid size adjustable. Go back to the rectangle generator and set the height like this. The only thing left is colors. If you are not new to Touch Designer, I suggest you to stop the video here and try to do it yourself. But I'll continue. Let's first create a palette. Just add some constant tops to the network and set colors. My main color would be white, so I'll duplicate it to give it a higher chance to be selected. Add a switch top. We want this index to be chosen random, so let's create a pattern chop. Type random, length 1, set amplitude to 6, since we have 6 colors, and interflow to get rid of the decimal part. The seed is gonna be defined by the index multiplied by parent parenthesis dot digit. Connect this to the switch index parameter. Now to set the color, we should go to the material and find line near color parameter. We should set the RGB values here. To extract these values, I'll use top to chop operator. We don't need the alpha. Let's add a null here and call it color. Then just refer to these values in the material color. To change the color, you can always go to the pattern and add some value to the seed. I kinda like that area. If you want to make it look more shaggy, go back to the replicator parameters and multiply it by, let's say, 2. Refresh. Now it generates an extra rectangle each row. So that's it for this tutorial. I encourage you to experiment with another shapes or parameters based on this technique. It's extremely flexible, but keep in mind that it can also be quite resource intensive, so if you want to duplicate objects and vary its translation, rotation and size only, you'd better use instancing. But that's for another tutorial.